We've got Verity Gilbertson from MLA coming to talk about Livestock Data Link, which is a new feedback tool which MLA have been working on. Verity's flown all the way down from Sydney and she's flying back again after this session today, so I hope you all give her a very warm welcome.
Thank you. Okay, well, my name is Verity Gilbertson and I work for Meat and Livestock Australia as a relationship manager in the value chain innovation team. So my main role is about working with our processors in implementing new technologies and innovations through their value chain. Today I'm here to talk to you about a new technology that is becoming available to you as producers to assist with you in meeting market specifications. So what is it when we talk about meeting compliance? What does this mean? So as previously mentioned by Tim and others today, processors obviously have customer requirements that they need to meet or specifications that they need to meet in terms of delivering a product to a particular market. So specifications can vary from, specifications are like hot standing carcass weight, pH, fat depth, marbling, dentition, sex, that sort of information that would be collected. So when we talk about specifications, they will vary for different markets or intended markets. So when your carcasses don't comply or are out of spec, then the processor needs to either find another alternate market for that carcass, and then they also look at having to replace that animal or that carcass with another animal, and then also it would mean that you would get a hit or a penalty for not hitting that spec. So why is it important to meet compliance? So in 2011 and 12, MLA did a research project where it looked at the processor level at, you know, assessing four specific markets where it showed that the Australian beef industry loses an estimated of 127 to 168 million per annum due to cattle being produced that were out of spec. So they were due to carcass downgrades for animals not meeting compliance or out of spec, so it was around 51 million per annum. It was also due to carcass condemns, which was around 64 million, and then also loss of meat and loss of value to meat and offal due to animal health and disease was around 12 million to 49 million per annum. So the question is we know that it's important to meeting compliance, so it's important to get feedback back to you and how you're meeting compliance. So how many of you here get feedback from your processors? Do you find that the level of information is the same? Is it different between processor to processor? So the reason why I ask these questions is feedback comes in a variety of formats. They can come as paper, email, fax, and the level of detail can vary as well. You do get feedback that tells you what your measurements for a specific animal and what your costs were that you received, the prices that you received. But do you receive feedback on what you did right, what you did wrong, and how you can improve? So we may have a solution for you, Livestock Data Link. Livestock Data Link is an enhanced carcass feedback and reporting system that's been rolled out by a supply chain basis. It allows you as a producer to identify opportunities in improving your compliance to market specification, and it also supports you to make business decisions on how you can improve your performance through solutions of feedback or library resources to help you make those decisions. So Livestock Data Link is like a web application that links slaughter data from the National Livestock Identification System and Meat Standards Australia databases with analytic tools, benchmarking reports, and solutions to feedback. So how does LDL benefit you as a producer? Well, it's a centralised source of information on quality aspects in terms of your red meat and livestock. It identifies non-compliant carcasses and the associated cost of non-compliance at an individual animal and herd mob level. It allows you to look at your performance benchmarking at a herd as well as at a state, regional and national level. And it also allows you to link your carcass performance outcomes to a library of solutions to address those non-compliant issues on farm. So how does LDL work? So what happens is you have individual carcass information that is uploaded, which is collected by your processor. So this is then linked to a target market. So before your animals are actually slaughtered or go through the kill floor, they are actually allocated a target market. That at the end of the day, this information, the carcass information, along with your target market, is uploaded to NLIS, which is then replicated into LDL. Then you, then a processor and you as a producer are able to access this feedback, and then you can see how your carcasses went in terms of compliance and non-compliance, and then it can, you can determine whether you need to make any changes or address any non-compliant issues on farm. So how do I measure up in Livestock Data Link? So we now know that you get individual carcass information and this is linked to a target market. So within LDL, there's an analysis grid. So this is where you will enter your processor market specifications. So this is where you enter your ideal weight ranges, P8, fat, ranges in there, and then you would put a discount in there. So when we talk about prices, we're not talking about the actual cost, we're talking about the discount or the penalty that is applied. So then what happens is LDL will analyse individual carcass performance against that selected grid within it, against the selected grid, and then what will happen, it will calculate the cost of non-compliance for each trait. So this is the opportunity cost of not meeting that market, that target specification, and it's based on those discounts of falling outside those ideal weight, like the ideal ranges or sweet spot that you might want to call it. So now that you've got this this information and you know how you comply or not non-compliance is, what can you do to improve? Well, one feature of Livestock Data Link is the library of solutions to feedback, which is the library of resources. So what will happen is when you're within LDL, there is a scatter plot chart or that graph that you can sort of see up there. If you hover your mouse over those different sections on the graph, you actually will highlight what the non-compliance was. So it could be too heavy, too fat, too light. And then here you can click on that segment and it will take you actually off to the Library of Resources where it will give you a brief overview of what the issue is and then give you some suggestions on how you can do this better next time or learning just some more information about it. So within LDL, you're actually able to see how you perform against other producers. It allows you to benchmark your carcasses against other producers' carcasses in that area. So that just allows you, you can look at it at a state or national or regional level to see how you performed against other producers in that area. Also, you're able to compare how your performance of your herd goes through comparative analysis reports as well. So another feature for Livestock Data Link, it is a one-stop shop for carcass feedback. So when we within LDL, you're also able to get your MSA information. So it gives you a high-level summary of what your MSA non-compliance was. So you still will need to go to my MSA for detailed information on how you perform, but here you can see where your carcasses graded, where they didn't grade, and the reasons why they didn't grade as well. So within LDL, you also can get your MSA index information. So what we've done is, I'm sure that might have been passed around, I've just provided you with some information on the MSA index, so some tips and tools, so you can just learn some more information about what the MSA index is. Also, LDL is looking at how we can incorporate animal health and disease feedback. So we have done some projects with the National Sheep Health Monitoring Project where we have created an LDL reporting interface for for health feedback. So that's currently being looked at, and we're looking at expanding this to cattle and sheep, and this should be done, hopefully be looking at becoming available within LDL over the next 6 to 12 months. So what I would like to do now is just to provide you with a video of just to show you some of the reports within LDL. So when you first go off to Livestock Data Link, the dashboard will open up. That's the first thing you see, and this provides you with the number of carcasses killed over a month. Then you can go to your grid setup, where you can either create a grid from scratch, which is from your processor, or use a grid wizard application, or you can just copy one. And here, this is where you enter the weight ranges, your P8, fat depth ranges, and add the discounts. You also are able to add discounts, add other attributes, so dentition, sex, meat colour, MSA index, and so on, as you can see on the screen there. Then what happens is you press save for that grid, and that will be saved under My Grids in LDL. Then you go off back to the dashboard. Just it's worth mentioning here, with your information, you can actually click on the month and see what your weekly breakdown is of your kill. If you click on the number, the carcasses, the bodies, it will go straight off to the carcass analysis report, and it will automatically put in the dates for you. Here on this screen, you can see that we're showing you that it shows you the information of where you go wrong, and then what you were non-compliant, and then it clicks you off to that solutions to feedback. So when you scroll down that page as well, you can see what your compliance was for each carcass trait. So you can see it for your overall compliance against weight, P8, fat depth, dentition, just can't see it very well, meat colour, and then your MSA index. And on those green hyperlinks, you can also go off to the library of solutions. It also just gives you further summary of what your minimum and maximum was for your weight and fat, and also your average. And then this is here where you can see your non-compliance count, your cost, and then your cost per head. So within LDL, you can go off and do some further analysis by compliance percentage. So this, just disregard that title, it's not correct. But this is where you can see where you're over and under spec in terms of your animals for each trait. And you can also look at that from a dollar perspective as well. We're going to have a look at the MSA summary. So as mentioned before, this is a one-stop shop of your MSA compliance. And so here you can see your graded, ungraded, the measurements minimum and maximum, and then the reasons of ungraded. And this is where you can click on the link and also go off to the solutions to feedback. And then you go back, and then there's just a graphical representation of what that ungrade looked for the reason of MSA non-compliance. So as we mentioned before, you can do comparisons in here. So you might want to do this across a month, or you might want to do compare on a plant on plant, or you might want to change your target market, or you might have a different grid that you might want to put across. This is where you can do that comparative analysis. So for this scenario, we're just going to do October and compare it to September. So as you can see, for the month of October, you had a high compliance, but then when you look in September, you are outside of spec. And it just provides you the comparisons of compliance, and then just gives you a graphical representation between the two groups. So within LDL, as mentioned before, you are able to benchmark. So this is where you can compare your carcasses against other producers in that state or region. But for this, we're just showing you the different regions that you can select for the state. But for this exercise, we're just going to look at it at a national level. And once you submit it and it opens, it shows your property is on the... So you'll identify on this screen down the bottom, it says this is your property, and then it shows you the benchmark. So as you can see, this producer is actually complying, is higher than what the national is for some aspects of the traits. As meant within LDL, you also have the ability to, there is a details report, so you actually are able to download this as a CSV file. So this just gives you the individual carcass information. So it shows you your NLIS ID, your RFID, shows you the different measurements for each animal. It shows you the cost of non-compliance, and then it will show you the reason of non-compliance, and then it also gives you your information on your MSA chiller assessment information. So if you actually want to download this, you might want to upload this onto your on-farm system where you can link your genetics information. You can do that from downloading this. And then you might just want to do further analysis or do your own sort of charts and things. So that's where you can download that from. And that's it for the... demonstration. So how do you get access to Livestock Data Link? So LDL is available through a processor. So we've got around 8 companies involved within LDL, ranging from at different stages from having this available to their producers to people just starting in the program, and we're working with them to get them this system rolled out to their suppliers. So we really encourage you to talk to your processor to see whether they're involved in the program, and if they're not involved, we do encourage them, and they're interested in part of being Livestock Data Link, we encourage you to suggest to get in contact with MLA to find out some more information. If your processor is involved within the Livestock Data Link, you can actually, to access it, you'll need to have your NLIS user ID and password to be able to use it. So if you don't have an NLIS account, you will have to register, you will need to create one through NLIS. And the first time when you go into LDL, you will need to register access. So just a couple of key points that I really want you guys to take home today. Livestock Data Link is an enhanced carcass feedback and reporting system that's been rolled out on a supply chain by supply chain basis. It identifies opportunities for you to improve your market, your compliance to market specification. And it also supports you as a producer to make business management decisions on how to improve your performance. Thank you.